Hello everyone, this is Payal Vaja. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will discuss about terminology used in transfer of technology, part 2. So let's get started. These are the list of contents we will discuss in this video. Various terminologies we will discuss. First one is installation qualification, operational qualification, performance qualification, process validation. What is qualification? What are the qualification batches? What is quality assurance? What is quality control? What is quality planning? Quality policy, as well as quality risk management. Receiving unit, sending unit, speaking, standard operating procedure. What is technology transfer report, as well as validation? What is validation master plan? What is validation protocol or validation plan? Or last one is, what is validation report? So we will discuss one by one. First one, what is installation qualification? The performance of test to ensure that the installation, such as machines, any measuring device, utilities, and manufacturing areas used in manufacturing process that are appropriately selected and correctly installed and operate in accordance with established specification, that are called as installation qualification. So installation qualification, that is a performance of any test which ensures that installation of machine, measuring device or manufacturing area that are used in manufacturing process. So any equipment or any area that are particularly used in manufacturing process that are appropriately selected and correctly installed or not, as well as all the machines, measuring device and manufacturing area, all are operated accordance with established specification or not, that are called as installation qualification. It is a one type of documented process that verify all the aspects of facility, utility, equipment that affect the product quality, adhere to the approved design specification, and that the piece of equipment or instrument that has been properly installed or not. So exactly, installation qualification, that is the one type of documented process which ensures that machine, measuring device, measuring area, all are installed properly or not accordance with established specification. Next one is operational qualification. What is operational qualification? It is a documented verification that the system or subsystem which performs as an intended over all anticipated operating ranges. That means operating qualification, it is an essential process during the development of equipment that is often used by pharmaceutical company. So operational qualification, it is an essential process during development of any equipment. And operational qualification can simply be defined as a series of tests which ensure that equipment and its subsystem will operate within their specified limit consistently and dependably. So operating qualification, it is a series of tests which assures that equipment as well as its subsystem will operate within their specified limit consistently as well as dependently. Next one is performance qualification. What is performance qualification? That is the documented verification that the equipment or system operates consistently and gives reproducibility within defined specifications and parameters for prolonged periods. So, performance qualification is a one type of documented verification. It gives equipment or system that are operates consistently as well as gives a reproducibility within defined specification as well as parameters for prolonged period of time. Performance qualification are a collection of tests that are used to verify that a system performs as expected under simultaneous real-world condition. So, performance qualification test requirements defined in the user requirements specification. So, what is the summary of performance qualification? It is the one type of documented verification that the equipment or system operate consistently as well as equipment and system gives the reproducibility within defined specification and parameter for prolonged period of time. Next one is process validation. What is process validation? It is a documented evidence which provides a high degree of assurance that a specific process will consistently result in a product that meets its predetermined specifications and quality characteristics. So, process validation, it is a one type of documented proof that gives the idea about or that provides a high degree of quality assurance that a specific process will consistently result in a product that meets its predetermined specification as well as quality characteristics. Process validation is the analysis of data gathered throughout the design and manufacturing of product in order to confirm that process can reliably output products of a determined standard. So, process validation, it is a documented evidence and it is the analysis of data gathered throughout design as well as manufacturing of product in order to confirm that process can reliably output products of determined standard or not. Next one is qualification. What is qualification? Action of proving and documenting that any premises, systems, and equipment are properly installed or work correctly and lead to the expected result. So, qualification means action of proving something or documenting in a written form that any premises, systems as well as equipment that are properly installed or work correctly, that is lead to the expected result. Qualification is often a part of validation. So, qualification, it is the part of initial stage of validation, but the individual qualification steps alone do not constitute process validation. So, qualification, it is the action of proving or documenting any premises, system, and equipment are properly installed and properly worked and give expected result. Next one is qualification batches. What is qualification batches? Those batches that are produced by receiving unit to demonstrate its ability to reproduce the product. So qualification batches that is produced by receiving unit. Why it is produced by receiving unit? To demonstrate its ability to reproduce the product or not. Next one is quality assurance. What is quality assurance? Quality assurance, it is a wide-ranging concept covering all matters that individually or collectively influence the quality of product. So quality assurance, it is a wide-range concept or a broad concept which cover all the matters that individually or collectively affect the quality of product. It is the totality of the arrangements made with the objective of ensuring that pharmaceutical products are of the quality required for their intended use. So, it is the totality of arrangements made with objective of ensures that pharmaceutical products are of quality required. So, pharmaceutical product required quality for their intended or effective use. So, quality assurance, it is a way of preventing mistakes and defects in manufactured product as well as avoiding problem when delivering product to the customer. So quality assurance, it is the way of prevent any mistake, any defect in manufactured product, and it avoids the problems when deliver the product to the customer. So which ISO 9000 defines as a part of quality management focused on providing confidence that quality requirements will be fulfilled. So what is the summary of quality assurance? Quality assurance means it is the way of preventing mistakes as well as defects in manufactured product and avoiding problems when deliver the product to customers. Next one is quality control. What is quality control? Quality control covers all measures taken, including the setting of specifications, sampling, testing, and analytical clearance to ensure that starting materials, intermediates, packaging materials, and finished pharmaceutical products conform with established specifications for identity, strength, purity, and other characteristics. So, quality control, which cover all the measures they are taken. Which type of measures are including the setting of specification, sampling, testing, analytical clearance. All the measures ensures that starting material, intermediate material, as well as packaging material and finished product conform with established specification for identity, strength, purity, and remaining characteristics. So it is a process by which entities review the quality of all factors that are involved in a production. So ISO 9000, which defined as quality control, is a part of quality management. So quality control, that is the part of quality management that are focused on fulfill quality requirements according to ISO 9000. Next one is quality planning. What is quality planning? That is the part of quality management and that is focused on setting quality objectives and specifying necessary operational processes and related resources to fulfill the quality objectives. So what is quality planning? Quality planning, that is the part of quality management that is concentrate on quality objective as well as specify necessary operational process and related resource to fulfill quality objectives. A quality plan, it is a document or a several documents that together specify quality standards, practice, resources, specifications, and the sequence of activities relevant to a particular product. So what is quality plan? It is defined as a method for measuring the achievement of quality objective. It is the method to achieve quality objective that are called as quality planning. Next one is, what is quality policy? Overall intentions and direction of an organization related to quality as a formally expressed by a senior management. So quality policy, it is an overall intention and direction of organization that are related to quality as formally expressed by senior manager. So quality in quality management system, a quality policy is a document that is developed by management to express the directive of the top management with respect to quality. So quality policy, it is a document that is developed by management to express the directive of top or senior management with respect to quality. Next one is quality risk management. Quality risk management is a systematic process for the assessment, control, communication, and review of risk to the quality of pharmaceutical product throughout the product life cycle. So quality risk management, it is a systematic process for the assessment, control, communication, and review of risk to quality of pharmaceutical product throughout product life cycle. Quality risk management, we will discuss in next lecture briefly. What is receiving unit and what is the sending unit? First one, receiving unit, the involved disciplines at an organization where a designated product, process or method is expected to be transferred. So receiving unit receive all the product, process or method for transfer purpose. While sending unit, the involved discipline at an organization from where a designated product, process or method is expected to be transferred. So sending unit send product, process or method for transferred purpose, while receiving unit receive the product, process or method. Next one is speaking. What is speaking? The addition of known amount of compound to a standard, sample or placebo, typically for the purpose of confirming the performance of analytical procedure. So exactly what is speaking? Speaking means addition of any known amount of compound to standard sample. Why addition of known amount of compound to the standard sample? Purpose is confirm the performance of analytical procedure. So by adding any known compound to the standard sample, check the performance of analytical procedure. Next one is SOP, Standard Operating Procedure. It is an authorized written procedure giving an instruction for performing operations not necessarily specific to a given product or a material. So, it is an authorized written procedure, standard operating procedure. It is an authorized written procedure that gives the instruction for how to perform or how to operate any instrument. Certain SOP may be used to supplement product specific master and batch production documentation. So, standard operating procedure, it is a set of step by step instruction that is compiled by organization to help a worker carry out complex routine operations. So, it is the step of step by step instruction that is compiled by any authority or organization for helping or to help any worker or students to carry out complex routine operation. What is the aim of standard operating procedure? Standard operating procedures aim to achieve efficiency, quality output, and uniformity of performance while reducing miscommunication and failure to comply with industry regulations. So, aim of SOP is to achieve efficiency, quality output, and uniformity of performance and reduce the miscommunication and failure to comply with industry regulations. Next one is technology transfer report. That is the documented summary of a specific technology transfer project, listing procedure, acceptance criteria, result achieved, and conclusion. So, technology transfer report, that is the document or a written procedure, that is a written document which contain summary of specific technology transfer project. So, in the technology transfer report, listing the procedure, acceptance criteria, as well as result, all are and conclusion. All are included in technology transfer report. And any deviation should be discussed and justified. So, technology transfer report, it is a documented summary of technology transfer project in a written form. So, it contain listening procedure, listing the procedure, acceptance criteria, result achieved, conclusion, and any deviation should be discussed and justified. What is validation? Action of proving and documenting that any process, procedure, or method actually and consistently leads to the expected result. So, validation means action of prove something and documenting any process, procedure that are actually meets to the expected result, that are called as validation. Next one is validation master plan, that are referred to as VMP, a high level document that establish an umbrella validation plan for the entire project and summarize the manufacturer's overall philosophy and approach to be used for establishing performance adequacy. So, validation master plan, it is a high-level document which establishes umbrella validation plan. So, that is the biggest validation plan for entire project, and it summarizes manufacturer's overall approaches to be used for establish performance adequacy. It provides information on the manufacturer's validation work program and define details of end time scale for validation work to be performed. So, validation master plan provides the information on the manufacturer's validation work program and it defines details of end time scale for the validation work to be performed, including statement of responsibility of those implementing plan. So, validation master plan involved in qualification of facility, defining the areas and system to be validated, and provides a written program for achieving and maintaining a qualified facility. Next one is validation protocol or a validation plan. It is a document describing the activities to be performed in a validation, including acceptance criteria for the approval of manufacturing process or a part thereof for routine use. So what is validation process or validation plan? It is a document that describes the activities that should be performed in a validation. What type of activities should be performed in a validation? Like acceptance criteria for the approval of manufacturing process. So it is defined as a written plan which describes process to be validated, including production equipment and how validation will be conducted. Next one is validation report, a document in which the records, result and evaluation of a completed validation program are assembled and summarized. So it is a one type of written document in which records, result and evaluation of completed validation process or program are summarized out. It may also contain proposal for the improvement of processes and equipment. So validation report, it is a one type of document which contains record, result, evaluation of completed validation program. That is a one type of summary. So it may also contain proposal for improvement of process and equipment. Thank you.